Welcome to Cleves Tech and another video in our Fooocus for Stable Diffusion series of videos. In this video, I will go over wildcards in Fooocus. Wildcards act as placeholders or variables in your prompts. When you use a wildcard, it allows Fooocus to insert a random element from a predefined list of options into your prompt. Don't miss out on my other videos covering all aspects of Fooocus from installation to poses and face swap.
Okay, so how do wildcards work exactly? Well, it's actually pretty simple. You just do the double underscore, the wildcard name, double underscore to close it, and then that's it.
Now, Fooocus comes with a couple different ones. Color is one of the ones that you can use, but you can create your own. I'll show you how to create them, where to put them, and actually even an easy way to create them. So you can make a huge list and not have to type the whole thing out. Okay, so while we have our motorcycles, as you can notice, we have some randomness, but this one looks blue, yellow, and I think these might actually be the same. The easiest way to find out is we can go into our log for our generated images. And as you can see on here, put in a black motorcycle, same thing here. You got a yellow motorcycle and a navy motorcycle. And that's all that the wildcards do, is it's gonna fill that in from that predefined list. That list right here, and I'll show you how to create that and everything, but this one does automatically come in Fooocus, and you can add to this list. The key thing to know about these lists when creating them, there's no commas or anything like that. Each word is on a separate line. So that will fill in whatever you have on each line when it loads it up. Now, another thing to keep in mind is you can actually use multiples and the same wildcard multiple times. So in this one, I put in a woman in a color wildcard, dress wildcard, which I created, standing near a color wildcard again, and then car. And it will fill those in as it creates the prompts. Okay, so we have our image generations. We have a variety of colors, a variety of different dress styles. Let's go into our log, and you can see here how it filled in the color and the dress type, and then the color again. And it got different colors. Originally, when they implemented this in Fooocus, it would only pull one time, but now they've changed that so it does pull different ones. So here it is, purple and purple, but that was just the randomness that factored into that. And that's really, for the most part, how wildcards work. One last thing I will give you an example of, this is a capability of it. I haven't really messed around with it. You can nest wildcards, so you can put wildcards inside of wildcards. So there's actually a color underscore flower wildcard, and because there's a color wildcard and a flower wildcard, so what this one does, it actually pulls in each of those wildcards, if you look in here, and creates a compound one, so you can nest those. I'm not a big fan, but I can imagine some people might find that useful. Okay, so we have our flowers and we have a dime. I'm not sure why we have a dime, but I'm sure we're gonna find out momentarily why we have a dime when we look at the log. Okay. So it's pulling from the color and then from the flower list and it's compounding them. Ah, that would explain why we got our silver dollar. So that's how wildcards work. So first I'm going to show you where the wildcards are stored in Fooocus, and then I'll show you how to create them, an easy way to create them. All they are is text files. So if we go into the Fooocus folder where we start off with, go into the primary Fooocus folder, then go down, you'll find a wildcards folder. You go into that, and each one of these, you'll find text files in here. Easiest way to do that is to right click and just create a new text document. We could do a list of wood types, and we would just open that up and type in the different ones that we want. That's one way you can do it. And that would be our own custom list. You can put whatever you want in there. That's all there is to making a wild card. I've got several different ones in here. I created one for dogs. And looking at that, no, I did not type that all in. I'll show you how to do that. I did one for dress types. Then you have an extended color list. I think this one might. Yeah, that one, you can use that instead of just the regular color. You could use extended color or just change that to color depending on what you want to do. Then you have the flower list that we were using before. This has a list of all the flowers. Nationality list is useful. That one's already in the Fooocus. That's already in this folder. Some of these I've created as well. And that's all there is to the wild cards. You just create a text file. You have a list of items in that text file on each separate line. Don't put a comma or anything like that. No comma separated values, or you just text file. Each one's on a separate line and it will pull each one of those in. Okay, now to show you how to easy ways to create these lists if you don't want to type out. Obviously, if you only want a few different things and you specifically want certain things in that list, then you type it out. But if you want to generate a list of things like colors or any other things without actually having to type them all out, this is a trick that I used. Any of the like ChatGPT or any of the other AI programs, I'm going to use the free version of ChatGPT 3.5. First, just to show you how one way that you could do it if you don't have the paid one. There's actually, if you have the paid ones, there's a little bit better way of doing it so you don't have to go through multiple steps. So all you want to do is ask it to create a list of common whatever. I'm going to do common foods. You can get a bit more specific on what you want. Top 100, top 50. Although if you put too many, it might not get the result that you want. And put each one on a new line with no other characters. Very specific about that. Otherwise, it will put commas. It may put quotation marks or something like that. So we specifically said on a new line with no other characters. I'm just going to hit enter. And it creates this list. All I need to do at that point is I can just either copy it all or hit copy code. And then go in and in my wildcard folder, I can create a new one called food. And then in that, I would go in and just paste. I'll save it. And now I have a food wildcard. So that's one way that you can do it. The other method you can do is if you have the paid version of ChatGPT. I'm not sure what else is out there and what the other ones offer. And then you can just ask it. I'm going to ask it to create a text file named food.txt with a list of the top 50 most common foods. I tell it to put each one on a new line with no other characters. And then I'm going to want to download the file. And then that should go ahead and create the list for me and create the file so I can just download it. I don't have to type it. I don't have to format it or anything. I'm going to let this do everything for me. Okay, so I have my file, so I'm just going to go ahead and download that file. And I'll save it as food.txt in here. And now I should be able to go in and generate some images using that new wildcard. Okay, we have our images and we have our variety of food from our, I'm supposing, our list, since I didn't type any of that stuff in. So let's load the log and see what it did. So we have spinach on a plate, beef on a plate, broccoli on a plate, and eggs on a plate. That covers everything you need to know about wildcards in order to start adding some randomness to your image prompts. If you found this video helpful, please do consider clicking the like button because it does help. And questions or suggestions for video ideas, please leave a comment. Thanks for watching, and don't forget that I do have other videos on Fooocus, and we'll have more in the future. Have a great day.